The desire of the Kurds along Iraq's northern border to govern themselves is receiving more resistance from Iraq's central government. Iraqi army forces are demanding Kurdish troops withdraw from oil fields and military bases around Kirkuk, a city in the Kurdistan region that voted for independence last month. Kirkuk also has 10% of Iraq's known oil reserves. Washington Post's Loveday Morris is in Baghdad covering the standoff, joins me now via Skype. First, Loveday, the significance of this, why is it so important?
Well, there's been a long time conflict between Baghdad and Kurdistan over these disputed territories, most significant of which is Kirkuk because of the oil reserves. But the referendum last month has really sharpened these disputes because you had Kurdistan voting for independence. That means that Baghdad is left obviously not wanting to cede these areas to the Kurds. It feels like it has to restake its territorial claim to these areas. So that's why we're seeing a lot of tension right now.
And just to give people a little bit of a brief timeline, Iraqi forces controlled this area for a while, and then, in June or so, ISIS took over the area, and then now it's kind of back in Kurdish hands?
Right. So in June 2014, Iraq lost the control of a lot of these areas. They did have forces there, then we had the huge collapse in the face of an ISIS offensive. Over 100,000 soldiers fled, and after that, Kurdish forces moved into some of these areas. Some of them they retook from ISIS, others they just moved into the vacuum. And so Iraqi forces haven't been in these areas since June 2014, and that's their main demand, that they return to the areas, the positions they were at before the ISIS advance.
What's the likelihood that this standoff right now turns violent into some sort of a civil war?
I think at this point, both sides don't want violence. Abadi, the prime minister, is really trying to defuse the situation, saying there's going to be no military attack, but at the same time there is this buildup of forces, so that I think they are trying to, in a way, intimidate the Kurds to withdraw from some areas, but they don't want to see a fight per se. But that's not to say that in this really tense situation that there can be a small conflagration, a small spark and things can turn violent quite easily when things are this tense.
Loveday Morris of the Washington Post joining us via Skype from Baghdad tonight. Thanks so much.
Thank you.